there. I hope you guys are okay. Right. I am Obianya Mori, and we will be studying literature in English. And we have series of texts for this class, but we'll start with second class citizen, defenses, and two points, African poem and non-African poem. Don't worry if you have done this, okay? What we are through with this text that I've mentioned now, we'll still go all over to study the whole text we have for this particular class, okay? So let's start with Buchi Emecheta's second class citizen. Of course, you know it's a prose, an African prose written by Buchi Emecheta. And I'm expecting at the end of this lesson, you'll be able to know a little profile about Buchi Emecheta, who she is, and her novels. Then you can tell us the setting. You can comment on the setting of this particular text. And then again, you can tell us the storyline of this particular prose, the sequential way in the story is related. So these are the things that is expected of you to know by the end of this lesson. So pay attention. If possible, also we can still talk about the themes. That's the central message that are contained in the text. Then let's start. Who is Buchi Emecheta? Buchi Emecheta, she's a Nigerian writer. She was born in 1944 in Lagos, where she attended Methodist Girl High School. That was in 1962. Later, she left Nigeria for London, where she studied there further and worked as a librarian and a community worker. Most of her novel deals on plight of women in their marriages, what they pass through in their different marriages, and it gives voice to womanhood. Then Buchi Emecheta, she wrote other literary works, which includes The Bride Price, The Slave Girl, The Joys of Motherhood, and other literary works. So these are little bits we can take for now concerning Buchi Emecheta. So let's see if there's a little element of this thing we see about her in her literary work. So about the novel, the setting. You still remember what the setting is? It has to do with time and the place, the circumstances surrounding the writer's story. The time, is it during war, pre-colonial era, during independence, those activities, the kind of life people were living at that time, is it the olden days? These are the things I expected under the setting. Then in this novel, the novel is set in Lagos, that's Nigeria, and also in London. The time frame revolves around the Second World War, the era of pre-independence, at the advent of civilization to Nigeria, when the British are coming into Nigeria to civilize Nigeria as a country. It's equally that time when the Western religion is gaining entrance in Lagos. Of course, you know, before the white men came, we are practicing the traditional religion. So we see the advent of that religion coming, but people are embracing the Christianity still. They are still going behind to practice their traditional religions. And we see in this novel, when Francis was preparing for his trip to UK, still a family member went behind to do some sacrifices to Obashiriba, despite the fact that they are members of the Jehovah's Witness. So these are around that time. The novel also features that time when Nigerian elites move heaven and earth in order to travel to London. Big people at that time, the you are struggling. I want to be a one, B, I want to go overseas. That was the event inherent as Adate time. Unfortunately, will I say fortunately for Ada, she is one of those ones that struggles to go to United Kingdom. Unfortunately, when they get there, they find out that all that glitters is not gold. Then again, through the characters of Ada and Francis, we get to see places in London like the Finchley, the Ashdown Streets, the Woodsworth, and other places. So, these are the settings, the places you encounter in this novel. Alright? Then let's move to the plot account in a nutshell. Sort of. And you know that the plot means the sequential arrangement of the storyline, the events that happen right from the beginning, sequentially, like that, development, the climax, then the whole story develops till the end. So how did this story happen? What is Buchi Emechaka telling us in this second class citizen? Then, this story centers on a female, the protagonist, that is Ada Ofili, that's her name, who was born in an Igbo family where, unfortunately for her, the females, they are relegated to the background without much education. Ada has a younger brother by name, Boy. Ada's duty is to assist her mother with domestic chores, cook food, wash, take care of the home, but don't go to school. Even if at all she's to go to school, it's only for her to learn how to write her name and to count. After all, she'll be giving up to marriage. But what happened? Boy, the younger brother is sent to an expensive school because he is a boy that is meant to be trending school. But it is not discouraged at that at all. In her stubbornness, she still struggled to attend school. What happened? There's this day that she sneaks out of the house and goes to the Methodist school. Then the teacher receives her. Mr. Pole, we are told that he's huge and the duck is very, very shiny. That's to show you a typical African man. But he did not chase him. He did not chase her away. He accommodated her and placed her beside a boy that has a crocro on the head that even gave her that writing materials. So she's welcome in the class that day. No, she's happy. She wants to go to school. She sneaks out. The parents, they were all over looking for her. And that event after that day mandated the parents to send her to school because the mother was forced by police to drink a bowl of garri. You know, that garri you add and add it a lot of water to rice. They forced her to drink it. It was a terrible punishment at that time, but not today, that we are dying of hunger today. And give it to somebody, you'll be drinking it and say, bring more, yes sir, bring more. So that was the kind of punishment that came to Ada's mother. And after that incident, she's enrolled in her school. Then what happened? Later on, the father died, and this made her mother to marry the husband's brother. And Ada and the boy, the brother, the both of them are giving out. Ada had to live with the mother's uncle. No? And what happened there? She also struggled to go to school. Initially, she's striving to enter into secondary school. No? What did she do? There is this day, she was sent to go and buy the food store with 2 shillings. She hid the money and she was punished severely because of that. But she did not cry. She did not cry. Unfortunately for her, that money she used it to enroll and she passed on scholarship. That's how she's able to enter into secondary school. The people said, okay, no problem. So far as she studied, don't worry. Later on, she will fetch us the handsome bride price, which she'll use in sending boy to school. She continued like that. As after some time, suitors started coming. Old men started coming for her, but she refused. She did not accept any of them. You know? But after some time, she graduates from the secondary school. She desires the home of her home. She wants a place she can call her home. That's when she meets Francis. She encounters Francis and jumps into marriage with Francis. I would say it's a love, it's a relationship built on love. But because Ada wants a home she can call her, but because of the things she has passed through in life. And it's important that you read this text. As I'm telling you now, there are details in these books that you need to read, not because I'm telling you. It is not the whole story. Remember, it's just in a nutshell. There are encounters, the things that she passed through. There are things that you need to know. Probably what transpired before this happened. And where can be so cunning to ask you the encounter between Mr. Okoli, Mr. Obi, and the son, Francis, when we are discussing a particular issue. Because you do not read it, you cannot tell us the encounter and the outcome of the conversation. So a lot of things took place in this prose. So I will encourage you to read the prose. So this now forced Ada to enter into marriage with Francis. By then she gets a job as a librarian, and she's paid handsomely. With the money she's earning, she uses the money to take care of the husband, the in-laws, and Francis, their sister. The money that the husband is earning is not even comparable to the one she's earning. So she's now the responsibility of the whole family lies on her. But she takes it with all pleasure, no problem complaining. At a time, the husband decides to go abroad to study. Said, okay, fine, well, no problem, I'll sponsor you, no problem. She sponsored the husband to England to study accounts. After some time, she decides to go and join the husband. No problem, you can come. She gathers the children. By then, she has given birth to two children. So the kind of treatment and the kind of thing she was expecting when she was preparing wasn't the thing she saw when she gets to England. The whole story changed entirely for Ada. It's just she enters into another phase of her life. The Francis she knows, although he's a male, African male that is conscious of his malehood, you know, it's the wall of the male, not the female. The female are supposed to be subjected under the male. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No problem, sir. That's the world he believes in. So, but Ada comes and, you know, she's struggling to make sure that things move well in her family. Francis will, he keeps studying. Ada keeps paying the bill. Francis will not find a job. Francis will not assist in the family. When the children keep coming, and Ada wants them to go for family planning, Francis refuses. You know, he doesn't even consider the situations of the family at that time. You know, upon that, Ada is receiving all marital abuses, beating here and there, but she kept on struggling to keep her family together. Upon all this, despite the maltreatment she received the handover from Francis, at the end, when she couldn't bear it anymore, what happened? He had to go to court for the court to annul it, to separate both of them. And Francis, being a wicked human being, what did he do? He burned Ada's manuscript. You know, she developed this idea, a dream of being an author, and she started developing on it, but Francis did not even recognize that effort. So the day they went for the court issue, he bought their marriage certificates, probably out of fear, so that the court would not see them as a married couple, in order not to jail him. So he denied them. He denied his family. That was how he was separated from his family. Both of them, they go their separate way, with Ada having the custody of the children, including the fifth pregnancy she was having at that time when she leaves the husband's home. So these are the few things that happened with the story. When you read it, you see a lot of things happened. The daily minders, her friends, the doctors going to the hospitals. A lot of things happened in this novel. So these are, in the nutshell, the plot line of this story. A second class citizen. Alright? Then let's move on. Next, we talk about the themes. The themes. We have themes like the concept of second class citizen. The concept of second class citizen. Then we have things like abuse of marriage. Abuse of marriage. Then again, we have stubborn female. Stubborn female. Then we also have unreciprocated relationship in marriage. Leads to failure in marriage. And other things. But I want us to discuss about one. Today, let's talk about the concept of second class citizen. This team, as you can see, the name second class citizen. When you look at it, the first thing that comes to your mind, second class. Okay, we have first person, and we have the second person. Okay, let's see. Then you start to relate it to the novel, the instances. The people that are related to this second class issue. Don't be surprised that it runs through this novel in two forms. In the form of sex of a child and in the form of racism. That's how the concept of second class citizen comes into play in this text. How? In the context of child sex. Although Philip, that's the protagonist, she is born into an Igbo tribe that believes in the dignity of a male. She's so unfortunate to be giving birth into a family where preferential treatment is accorded to a male child over a female child. How true is that? Boy, that's younger brother, is privileged to be born as a boy. And that's made him to attend an expensive school because it is a first class. You see now, there won't be a second class without a first class. So boy now is a first class and another is a second class. So you see it now. So sending her to school, if at all, it's just for her to learn how to count and write her name. After all, she's only a second class citizen that'll be giving up to marriage. Then again, Ada is able to attend secondary education because she struggles for it. But then, they believe that if she studies, that she's going to fetch a handsome, bright prize, which will see a boy through education. That's why they even allowed her to finish the secondary school, although it was on scholarship. Then again, going beyond Ada's family again, she marries into yet another class-conscious family, that is Mr. B, to start with. Mr. B, he relegates his wife to the background. He even maltreats his wife because she's a female. That's a second class citizen whose role is to keep house, to give birth, and to receive blows whenever the husband feels there. Like, remember when Francis was telling Ada over there in the UK? After all, it happens in their family. The mother can't do anything. You see now, so he grows up in that lineage. These are how men are supposed to handle the female. The men are first class citizens, while the females are second class citizens. So the same thing is applicable to Francis, that's her husband. He grows up in a lineage where females are nothing but housekeepers, breadwinners, punch bags. They don't even contribute in family matters. They are just there. The husband instructs them, the males particularly instruct them on what to do and what not to do. That is second class citizen. Then again, this is the situation between Francis and Ada. Francis, the first class, whose job is to study, come home, eat, rest. That's all. While the second class citizen gets to work, keep the house, provide for the family, take care of the children, get pregnant, and keep the household together. The list is endless. And this is how Ada is one of the second class citizens. So, Ada lives through all this until she decides to try living a first class life. That's why she decides to separate from the husband to close this chapter of second class citizen in her life. So you see the second class citizen affecting her from the house, from her father's house to her husband's house. Then again, second class citizen in the context of racism. Living in England as a black in those days entails encountering some challenges as seen in the novel. You see, when they are hunting for house, there is this particular house over the phone, they agree that there is a room. When they get there, unfortunately, they are colored people. No house again for them. You see now, because showing now that the whites are first class citizens, while the blacks are second class citizens. So you see a lot of this happening over there in the United Kingdom. So we see this also repeated in manifesting in some characters like Babalola and most of the African citizens that gets over to UK to study. So these are in two ways in which second class citizens team runs through the novel. Alright, I think we'll stop here. Next time we'll talk about the characters and the language and style encountered in this Buchi Emechata's second class citizen. Alright, please, like I said, go through the novels, read them through and through. Questions can come from anywhere. And you see, in this novel, we have a lot of characters, a lot, that even where you can pick out one insignificant character, ask you to talk about that person. Or what transpired between the main character and that insignificant character. Because you do not read them, you wouldn't know what to say about that particular character. So read them, and as you read them, I want you to do this on your own. You answer them. Alright? Take it down, rest, answer them. Do this on your own. Examine the theme of abuse of marriage. Then again, discuss in full the events of two quarrels between Ada and Francis. Of course, if you do not read the prose, you can't answer this. So I encourage you, read the prose so that you know the particular quarrel you pick up, because there are a lot of them. Quarrel over pregnancy, over daily minder, a lot of them. You can pick only just two and discuss it in full. Then examine the theme of abuse of marriage. So if you're answering the bear in mind, you can start by defining it. Then tell us the people involved, the instances where this abuse in marriage occurred, then you can now conclude. And please, while writing, remember to develop using your paragraphs. It's very important. You can start in the first with the first paragraph introduction, and make sure that each point starts with a new paragraph. In this way, you score your complete marks. Don't go jumping all your points in one particular paragraph. It doesn't help. Alright, so consider this while writing this assignment. Thank you.